part of our own domestic laws. And a very important article is that it prohibited extraordinary rendition by definition, by expression, express words, not by implication. So Nigeria broke its own laws, so the people tend to think that, well, we are trying to make Nigeria's sovereignty subject to international law. No, international law implications are there, but this is also part of our own law. So what Nigeria has done has triggered a multi-judicial response, including, of course, that of international law, Britain, and China. So this is what we are dealing with right here. And to confirm to you that what happened to Martin Landekano is wrong, is what is happening in Benin right now. So if Nigeria believes that it's easy to go into another country and grab a suspect, and possibly, you know, remove that suspect and land the suspect in Nigeria, that's what's today in the case of Igbo. So it's playing out in the public. So there is going to be a lot of new dimensions that are going to see as this matter is done. Thank you very much. I've heard of a man who in 1984 triggered consequences as well. So I'll play back to that 1984.
Amila. Abil. See him.
3 for the Dunamis 5 case, and as it is, they are giving judgments right now.
Then two, that is the intention authority, in this case the SSS, to give us access to apply. Life of life about the way a manner will see it. But that's the case, we don't have the amount of what's due. And only yesterday we had a struggle all over the children's family. I have taken away from I have been taken away from here. And I can't confirm the first of the time. So the court has been and we feel that it's the intention authority that we should have access to here. Also, it's 5 days to be removed. So, but I have been agreed, and we are going to see them from now. So, and we have an application to get it transferred to the correctional center today, which was served on the parliament on 17th of July 2021. Only for on the 14th of July, yes, 2021. Only for us to ambush this one with the counter-based grant application. We wouldn't want to go into the merit because the court is actually not ready to go on with that. So on the next agenda, we are going to have a time. No, I have said to you, we are aware that international community is going up to the and they are aware that the time to come
out of the country.
So,
we are
going to have a time today. Government, USS, and all the authorities concerned to be heard upon by international community. Because UK, US are in effective communication with our elected people as to what is happening in this case. I can't confirm that to you today. As I speak to you now, I don't want to mention the international media organization who are following up this case. Who are these people today? Who are these people today?
Thank you. Thank you. Do you have your lawyer arrested?
No, no, no. No,
okay, well, you're arrested.
No, no, no.
What happened? You have to arrest him. What's your view on
that? Well, the situation whereby lawyers we are to criticize today, we are brutalized kind of. You are not allowed inside the court because we are suggesting the system is down the number of prayers. I know this is
your phone.
This is a case that rose close to this. And
where you?
Right,
your phone has gone.
So every woman, every employer doesn't want to know what's happening. So, and that has resolved with the court.
What is your income number?
Yeah, chief.
We are going to have families. We are going to have many of them. I was just informed in court that many of them were very people that came here with anything. So, and I'm urging the authority. I am urging the authority to find this video to release those who were called to witness the truth of the day. They were not violent. There were many here to witness the truth of the day. And it's your personal right to be called to witness the truth of the day. If you are limiting, if you have a restriction to number of people,
Seven people were arrested.
four out of those were.
There is my camera. Where is it?
Inside.
Yeah?
Don't worry, see.
What is it?
This one just gone down.
As my colleague informed you, the international legal order has been triggered by a process prescribed by most authorities to the suspension of the international legal order. The position of Nigeria over this matter is no longer exclusive. You have more multi-divisional people coming in, centers coming into play here. So it's not something that there's a wiggle room for the country. And we have to cross that bridge before we get to the bridge of saying guilty or not guilty. We have to cross the bridge of this very horrendous conduct that Nigeria thinks. Well, it surprised us. Nobody told us anything. We came here expecting to see him, and everything. The crowd that came here was expressing it. So this is one of those draconian things that we are fighting against. You see, we don't want to mention that. A policy at this point is roiling the citizens of Nigeria, and the protest that is said is showing itself in various forms. It's showing itself in revolution now. It's showing itself in the agitation to have a separate state. It's showing itself in resources. It's showing itself in insults. If you are not doing this, you are already going to be having these negative reactions from your citizens. If you do it right, then your citizens will be happy and they won't have any reason to dissent. Okay? So that's what's going on. And today, they prove themselves capable of continuing those things by arresting innocent people that came to express solidarity in the Nnamdi.
We're told by some people that Nnamdi Kanu was actually brought to this court premises, but he wasn't presented in court.
We didn't see him. We didn't see him. So if they brought you, they spitted him away.
No.
Because you can't have a trial in absentia when you're inside jurisdiction. So the court is interested in knowing whether Nnamdi Kanu has been removed from her jurisdiction.
How prepared are you now to see Nnamdi Kanu, since the judge has
actually said that? Well, I've seen him a few times, but you see, why it became an issue in court today was that he was hoping for a miracle sign, and it was a discretionary matter. They put the PSA decide when he's going to see him. But right now it's no longer discretionary. The court order has issued that we're entitled to see him twice a week. So
at what time is
it? Well, some afternoons and all that. Okay, all right.
Are you happy about that?
Yes, we're happy. Very happy. Thank you, thank you.
Go down now. Ambrose, go down now. Go down right now.
Come on. Except if there are compelling circumstances that doesn't allow that person to come to court. You can try somebody in absentia. That they didn't bring him to court shows that they didn't engage in any trial today. They just came and engaged in theatrics, as usual.
What of the arrest? How did you retain your freedom?
I was arrested by the police right in front of the courtroom, and they dragged me on the street and took me to one of the stations at the federal secretariat, where the DPO then started changing his phone. We insisted that we committed no crime by coming to court. One of our intention was to see Kanu and to watch the trial, because I have been in this kind of situation before. So I know where he is, I know what he's going through. So they took me there. Apparently, I think they just don't want me to come in contact with him or be part of the trial. They even said that they had my name listed as one of the persons banned from entering the court premises today. So when they got tired of holding me, they drove me back here. The trial was still on. I tried to get into the place. They took me back again, seized all my devices, but they've now returned them to me. And I'm a free man, at least for now. And I'm going back also upstairs to another case. As you can imagine, this continues. You know, nobody can suppress the people who are the generals of freedom. Nobody.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.